Again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome out to the Tennessee National Raceway. This is time for our Track Talk Driver Profile of the Week. This is brought to you in cooperation with THR Productions along with the Tennessee National Raceway. Want to get our sponsors in. Sponsors for Tennessee National are 412 Market, TNT Auto Body, TNK Auto Repair, O'Reilly's Auto Parts, RockAuto.com, Commodore Hotel, Advantage Cut Lawn Care Service, Cherry Photography, and of course THR Productions. In our Track Talk this week, we got a driver of the number 27 Dwarf Car who's invading the track here this evening. Sponsored by Hardison Market out of Columbia, Tennessee, the driver known as Chris Crutcher. Chris, welcome out to the Tennessee National Raceway.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate it. We all enjoy coming out here and running.
Good deal. And what are we looking at when we say dwarfs? What are we actually looking at as far as the fans are concerned? And even some of these racers that don't know what a dwarf car is, tell us what the difference is in a dwarf and, let's say, a mini stock.
Well, our cars, they are kind of a mini look to a 1928 to a 1948 model regular size car. But we run little 600 fuel injected Suzuki motors. You can run any motor as long as it's a 600. So.
Okay, and you're just talking about the other drivers that's here, Chris. And you guys, you know, racing is more of a family-oriented thing, especially in the pits out here. You know, we got all our fans coming in. Got moms, dads, grandpas, and all that. I know it's family there, but family in the pits, we were talking earlier, you know, family in the pits is more than just, you know, your cousin.
Yeah.
Your family is the other racers that's racing with you. And these guys do, you know, they're a real big family back here. Somebody breaks something or whatever, you got everybody pitching in. Is that the way it is with these dwarf cars?
Yeah. If you sit there and say you have a flat tire and somebody has an extra wheel and tire, and they'll let you put it on your car, and after the race is over, you can go home with that wheel and tire, and they will never ask for it back. You know, that it's yours to keep, you know.
I understand.
So everybody just pitches in and helps each other, you know, and we all get along. So we might not look like it on the racetrack, but when we're off the track, then we all get along.
Well, when you're on the track, each of you's going for the win. That's just like any other division here. Everybody goes for win. And I know, you know, tempers every now and then, unfortunately, go a little awry, so to speak. But outside of that, I know it's all family-oriented. You know, that they, you might get mad at them this week, but next week, you know, you might need a part from them.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's just the way it goes. Chris, is this the first time the Dwarf Car has actually invaded the Tennessee National this year? What do you think about the track?
Oh, we love the track. I mean, for as small as our cars are, this is the best track that we've came to run on because it's so smooth. And we do run asphalt. And to change the car over from dirt to asphalt, I mean, we don't do a whole lot to them. You know, we just throw dirt tires on them and let it go. So this track right here is ideal for us because it is so smooth.
And I agree, I've heard other drivers, not just, you know, the dwarf cars coming in, but all these visiting the legends and all that to come in here, they talk about how smooth the track is and how true it is to the car. You know, that, you know, of course, the hard racers and the bigger ones, I know they got to work on their setups, but like you say, a lot of guys just throw the tires on and come home.
Yeah, I mean, that's exactly what we do. I mean, there's a few people, you know, they'll raise them up a little bit because, you know, they have them so low for asphalt, but I mean, we was up here 2 weeks ago and I never did raise my car up, and It was dragging the ground out there a little bit, so I had to make sure I raised it up a little bit for this race, so hopefully it'll work out for us.
You're absolutely right, and it's my bad. I forget about you guys being here a couple weeks ago. We had a first race of our mini stock going on, or not the mini stock, but the I can't even remember the class now, but another class going on. The E-Mods, that's right. Thank you, Stephen. Had our first race of our summer shootout series of E-Mods, a busy schedule going on, and I do recall you guys been out here. And I love the sound of them engines. When them engines go by and it sounds like, I've heard some of these youngsters out here, it's the Bumblebee. Get excited about it. Do kids more take in like the Dwarf cars than they do the other cars when you guys go to all tracks? I know they do here, but do they do it at other tracks as well?
Yeah, I mean, the kids love our cars. I mean, if any kid wants to come down and sit in them and play around in them, I mean, we're more than welcome to have them come in, because there's not too many adults that can fit these cars. So, I mean, you know, but I mean, one thing we are trying to do is get the word out about Dwarf racing around here, because you know, we would like to get a lot more people involved, and to let you know, you can buy one race ready and starting at $2,500 up to $5,000, you know, just depends on, you know, what you like. So I mean, it is cheap fun, you know.
Well, and that's good. You know, a lot of people want to go racing, don't want to spend the big bucks on getting in your super lates or your limited late models or your open wheel modifieds. And there is some, you know, less expensive groups. You know, you can drop down, like your open wheel modifieds, you drop down to your E-Mods. In yours, you can get a fully charged engine, good racing. I mean, you know, as far as the Dwarfs are concerned, like you say, real inexpensive to get into, especially for a hobby.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of us have different hobbies, and some of them cost a lot more than others. And the Dwarf car, like you said, you get it pretty cheap.
Yeah. Well, see, that's why we all went to the 600 engine this year, because last year we was running the 1100 Suzukis. And to have the car, the motors, we was paying in between $1,000 to $1,500 for the motor. And you can buy a 600, you know, today for $400, you know, so we're trying to keep the cost down, you know, for everybody.
And that's a good thing. That, you know, that's what a lot of your racetracks are going to, a lot of your drivers, you know, trying to find that less expensive way. You know, sponsorships, you know, kind of dwindle here and there. So you find your less expensive way. And I'm glad you guys have found one in the Dwarf cars. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we're with our driver of the number 27 Dwarf car that'll be out here on our racetrack here at Tennessee National Raceway later on this evening. He's sponsored by Hardison Market out of Columbia, Tennessee. It's driver Chris Crutcher. Chris, what got you into racing?
Well, my father got me into racing. He, I mean, we went every Saturday night up there at the fairgrounds. And so I got interested in a legend car. And I couldn't afford it, so he footed the bill, and so we went and raced the legend car. Well, whenever he, you know, passed away, there wasn't no more money, so I, you know, gave it up for 5 or 6 years, and I said, you know, I really love racing, so I need to find a cheap way to get back into it. So I met up with these guys that run these Dwarfs and talked to them, and they set me up in the right direction, and I went out and bought one, and my wife didn't like it too well, but you know.
Of course not.
But that, I mean, I do want to thank my wife. She puts up with a lot, and my kids, you know, they sacrifice a lot too, so thanks to them.
Thanks to them, and it enables you to come out here and have fun and enjoy yourself, right?
Yeah.
What's your favorite moment in racing, Chris, as far as you being at the track or on the track? What is your best moment of racing?
Well, I would say my best moment of racing is we was running down at Twin Fountains in Shelbyville, Tennessee, and we was running a legend car. Well, Reed Sorensen, everybody knows who he is. Well, he come up to run a legend car with us, and we beat him. So that was my favorite moment there.
Always nice to be one of those NASCAR guys that, you know, in the NASCAR series. Always great to see them. and beat them, especially at their own game, so to speak.
That's right.
Well, Chris, best of luck to you this evening out here at Tennessee National. We want to thank you and the other drivers for the Dwarf Cars coming in, and definitely want to thank you for joining us here on Track Talk Profile here at Tennessee National Raceway. Best of luck to you this evening, and stay safe. Best of luck the rest of the year as well.
Well, thank you very much, and on behalf of all of us, we appreciate y'all letting us come out and run.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that's Chris Crutcher driving the number 27 Dwarf Car. Be hitting the track here at Tennessee National later on this evening. That's this week of Track Talk Profile Driver of the Week. Until next time, Godspeed.